Well, it's time to do a change on the Jeep Grand Cherokee. 1995, it's a 5.2, and I'll show you how to do it. So first, I run it for 2, 3, 4 minutes. Get the oil warmed up in the engine. Make sure it's in park, and the parking brake is pulled, just to be safe. So here's what you'll need. You need a funnel, a oil filter wrench, another wrench, 9/16 for the drain bolt, 5 quarts of oil filter. I would recommend some gloves, it gets messy, and also some rags to get oily. And also not pictured is a oil pan to catch all the dirty oil. So next is to drain the oil. 9/16 bolt for the drain pan. Watch for the exhaust. Might be a little warm. I have the oil pan out ready. There we go. And just be sure not to drop the bolt in there. Otherwise, you might be fishing for it. And there it is. Set the drain bolt aside and clean it off. That oil is dirty. Only has about 2,000 miles on it. And wait for that to finish up. I would say now it's about time to put the drain bolt back in. Get nice and snug. There. Next is the oil filter. Now, doing the oil filter, you will learn that the Jeep Grand Cherokee, since it is built with a little bit of off-roading in mind, it is also a green and environmentally friendly vehicle. And when you change the oil filter on these, it has a tendency to let the oil go back into the environment, which is where it came from. And yeah, you will see. So there it is. I have my oil pan ready. There's the oil filter with the wrench around it. This one's on tight. There we go. I am filming this with a GoPro in the case, so if oil gets on it, it's okay. I just unscrew it slowly, and then after the oil gets all over the place, I wipe it off. There we go. Nope. Clean that up. Wasn't ready for it as I thought it was. See, I told you it gets all over the place. And I will wipe all this up when I'm done. There's the starter. Transmission cooler lines. This was factory equipped with a tranny cooler and skid plate here, skid plate under the transmission or transfer case, and a skid plate under the fuel tank. Okay, oil filter is coming out. It will be full of oil. There it is. A filter. I did not put that in there. Okay. For the new oil filter, I like to put a little rim of oil on the seal, on the top of it, that rubber seal. Just like that. And then screw the new one back in place. Oh, I got threaded first. Which I'm not doing a very good job of. There it goes. So to torque it, you get it as tight as you can by hand. And then with the oil filter wrench, give it another half turn, I think it is. Yep, oil filter's on and tightened, and everything's cleaned up, ready to add oil to it. So there's where the oil filler cap was. Make sure you have a clean funnel. And next is to dump the oil in. I cannot talk today. So I'm using a 10 weight 30 partial synthetic oil, and this engine takes about 5 quarts. Should be about all of it almost done there. Alright, so oil's been added to it. Run the vehicle for a few minutes, get the oil pumped around inside the engine, get up to operating temperature. And then check the oil level. Here it's, I checked it and it's up to the full mark. So that part's all done. So if your Jeep came with a VIC, vehicle information center, like this one, you'll have to reset the mileage on it on the service. So turn on the ignition. Little chime. Hold, let's see. Then you hold the set button down. There you go. So I press select, waited a second, and then I press the set button when it said 0 miles of service, and then it reset it. So, ready to go.